The name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I welcome you all for this worship service. Shall we all bow our heads and look to God in prayer? Gracious God and loving Father, we come into your presence with hearts full of thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord, for redeeming us through your Son, Jesus Christ. And we also thank you, Lord, for the sufferings that your Son undergone to save the humanity. And we are so thankful and we are blessed to worship the risen Lord Jesus Christ in our day-to-day life, O Lord. As we begin this worship service, we beseech your kindly presence to take care of us and lead us to understand the meaning of Christ being the way amongst us. I commit each and every one of them who have joined this worship service to give you honor and glory, O Lord. In Christ's mighty name, we pray. Amen. Let us continue to worship the Lord Almighty by following the second order of worship service found on page number 42 in the CSI Book of Common Worship. Let us worship God. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. Grace to you and peace from God our Father, Lord Jesus Christ. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Grace, mercy and peace will be with us from God the Father and from Jesus Christ, the Father's Son, in truth and love. Let everyone who is thirsty come. Let anyone who wishes to take the water of life as a gift. The Lord is near to all who call on him. to all who call on him in truth. O Lord, open our lips and our mouth shall sing forth your praise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Adoration of the Trinity. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Glory be to you, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he who has come and is to come in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, O Almighty. Holy are you, O Almighty. Holy are you, O Immortal. Holy are you, O Immortal. O Lord, our Redeemer, who was crucified for us, have mercy upon us. O Lord, our Redeemer, who was crucified for us, have mercy upon us. O Lord, Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us. O Lord, Holy Spirit, have mercy upon us. O Lord, accept our praise and praises and have mercy upon us. O Lord, have compassion and mercy upon us. Let us enter into the act of confession. If we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves. The truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he who is faithful and just will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. I will get up and go to my Father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe the good news. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our own weaknesses, but we have one who in every respect has been tested as we are, yet without sin. Therefore, let's all kneel and examine ourselves in silence. Let us humbly confess our sins to the Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful God, we erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we should have done. And we have done those things which we should not have done. And there is no health in us. But you, O Lord, have mercy upon us, miserable offenders. Spare them, O God, who confess their faults. Restore them that are penitent according to your promises declared to humankind in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful God, for his sake, that we may hereafter live a godly, righteous, just life to the glory of your holy name. Amen. May the Almighty and merciful Lord grant us pardon and remission for all our sins, time for amendment of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Now we'll have the scripture portion read to us. First, we'll have the Old Testament lesson.
The first lesson is taken from Exodus chapter 14, verses 10 to 20. Reading from the NKJV version, Exodus chapter 14, verses 10 to 20. And when Pharaoh drew near, the children of Israel lifted their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians marched after them. So they were very afraid, and the children of Israel cried out to the Lord. Then they said to Moses, "Because there were no graves in Egypt, have you taken us away to die in the wilderness? Why have you so dealt with us to bring us up out of Egypt? Is this not the word that we told you in Egypt, saying, 'Let us alone, that we may serve the Egyptians'? For it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than that we should die in the wilderness." And Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall see again no more forever. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace." And the Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry to me? Tell the children of Israel to go forward, but lift up your rod and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, and the children of Israel shall go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. And I indeed will harden the hearts of the Egyptians, and they shall follow them. So I will gain honor over Pharaoh and over all his army, his chariots and his horsemen. Then the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord, when I have gained honor for myself over Pharaoh, his chariots, and his horsemen." And the angel of God who went before the camp of Israel moved and went behind them, and the pillar of cloud went from before them and stood behind them. So it came between the camp of the Egyptians and the camp of Israel. Thus it was a cloud of darkness to the one, and it gave light by night to the other, so that the one did not come near the other all that night. Here ends the reading. Thanks be to God.
Now we'll have the gospel lesson. Kindly stand for the gospel lesson.
The gospel reading for today is taken from John's Gospel, Chapter 14, verses 1 to 7. John 14, beginning from verse 1. "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. My Father's house has many rooms. If that were not so, would I have told you that I am going there to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus answered, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you will know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Here ends the reading. Thanks be to thee, O Christ.
We must go as the light to the nations. Take up his cross and follow where he leads. We must go as the light to the nations. Prepare to wear his crown of thorns, to bring his peace.
Cast your cares upon him. Lay your life upon him, for only He is worthy to stand. In tribulation, trials and sorrows, when you can't see through tomorrow, He'll reveal to you the frailty of a man. Cast your cares upon Him, lay your life upon Him, for only He is worthy to stand. In tribulation, trials and sorrows, when you can't see through tomorrow, reveal to you the frailty. Can you reach to love your neighbor? Will they see the sweet, sweet Savior shining through the charity you give? Do you hear His call to follow? You must lay down your life to follow. Humility, cast down your must go as a light to the nation. Take up His cross and follow where He leads. We must go as a light to the nation. Prepare to wear His crown of thorns, to bring His peace. Cast your cares upon Him, lay your life upon Him, His faithfulness and love who's always there. Do you hear His call to follow? You must lay down your life to follow. Humility, cast down your cares.
We must go as a light to the nation. Take up His cross and follow where He leads. We must go as a light to the nation. To wear His crown of thorns, to bring His peace. We must go as a light to the nation. Take up His cross and follow where He leads. We must go as a light to the nations, prepare to wear His crown of thorns, to bring His peace.
Greetings to you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. It gives me immense pleasure to share the word of God with you this morning. Shall we all bow our heads and look to God in prayer? Our loving Heavenly Father, once again we come into Your presence and commit ourselves to hear Your word, O Lord. Speak to us so that we might grow more in our faith journey. Bless each and every one of them who are listening this sermon, O Lord. In Christ's mighty name we pray. Amen. Once again, greetings to all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And today, the whole world is facing so much of pressure, so much of pandemic situation, and the difficulties, and people around the globe is experiencing day by day is increasing. And the life which we are experiencing is not the usual life, but then it is different altogether. We are not able to meet one another. We are not able to dine with one another. We are not able to have fellowship because of the social distancing. And usually, at times, we also speak about this social distance in our own circumstances, where we talk about the elite and poor, the educated and the illiterate. But now the social distancing can be understood in different way, where we have to keep this social distancing even between the elite, between the poor, even among the educated people. So we also hear so much of news saying that many people are dying and many people are losing their lives and many are affected by the spread of COVID-19. And in this situation, can we say Christ can be our way? The theme for us to meditate is that believing in Christ the way. Believing in Christ the way. How can we understand the concept of way? If someone wants to reach some place and if the person is standing at the crossroad, he is trying to ask for a way, right? If, for example, if you are the person is standing at the crossroad in front of the Stevens, if the person is asking for the route to go towards Mysore, and we also say, yeah, take your right from the main gate and then you can reach Mysore. So way becomes very, very important in all our life situations. And also we also in our own life situation, we also tend to see who can be a role model and who can lead us, who can lead us, who can show us a way to reach the culmination of our life or to reach the peak or to reach something which can be understood, which can be honored by all. So Christ is very much seen for us to prepare a way and also to give us the way. If you look at the Old Testament lesson, Exodus chapter 14, verses from 10 to 20, here we could see the Israelites were crossing the Red Sea, right? Israelites were crossing the Red Sea. Moses, Aaron, and all his company, all the Israelites were brought out from the Egypt, and now they are ready to cross over Red Sea. But they are going far away from Pharaoh, and Pharaoh started to chase all the Israelites, and Pharaoh also started to draw near to the Israelites, and they are looking back and they are very much fear about the chariots, about the soldiers, about all the chariot drivers, because the army is very strong and they are able to see the armies nearing them, they are approaching them. So they are very much scared, and in that scared situation they started to murmuring about the Lord Yahweh. And here we could see they are shouting at Moses, and they said to Moses, was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? What have you done to us, bringing us out of Egypt? Is this not the very thing we told you in Egypt? This is what they're shouting at Moses. They're complaining to Moses. They say, this is what we said earlier. We know very well that we will struck one day or the other. We will struck at one place. They feel Egypt was better than the present situation. Egypt was very much pleasant than the present situation. Thus they say, we should have gone back. We'll get back to Egypt to have our own lifestyle where we can also work as a slaves and we'll have food. But here we have a great obstacle in front of us. The Red Sea is before us. How can we cross this Red Sea? And in this situation, Moses tells to his people, the leader is very much courageous, the leader is very much straight, the leader is very much God-fearing. So he says boldly, do not be afraid, stand firm. Do not be afraid, stand firm. And see the deliverance that the Lord will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall never see again. What is lovely promise that is given for the Israelites through Moses. The Egyptian whom you see today, you will not see him again. You will not see them again. Many times we also, when we go through obstacles in our lives, when we face a lot of challenges, we see and we also murmur to God Almighty, saying, God, why is that happening? And at times people also say, if you go and interview with the converts, new converts, they will say, we were so happy when we were worshipping idols. We were so happy when we were having our own forefathers God as our gods. But after coming to knowing the Christ, coming to taste the love of Christ, after experience the salvation act of Christ, inside the church community, we are not able to be in a happy mood. We are not able to experience peace. We were so happy, we were very much safe, but we are not able to realize the goodness that we were enjoying earlier. At times we murmur. And sometimes even our own Christians, I mean, like the traditional Christians, used to ask, is God? Why God should allow all these things? Is God really who can care for me? Is there any almighty power? Is there a supernatural power to protect me? Why should I suffer like this? But here the promising word comes, do not be afraid, because God is there to protect you. God is there to take away. God is there to remove the Egyptians. God is there to remove your difficulty. God is there to remove your unpleasant situations. So the Lord will fight for you, and you will have only to keep still. If you commit your race, if you trust in the Lord Almighty, and you have to do what you have to do, you have to be still, and Lord will fight for you. My dear friends, do we have this kind of hope in the Lord Yahweh? That He can direct us, He can guide us, He can take us further. So here, God is speaking to Moses, why do you cry out to me? Why are you crying? What's happening to you? At times, no, we cry. And God is speaking to Moses, but you lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the Israelites may go into the sea on dry ground. Then I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they will go in after them. And so I will gain glory for myself over Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and his chariot drivers. My dear friends, God is there to help us in many ways. God can open up streams in the wilderness. When God can open up stream in the wilderness for Hagar, when Hagar cried to the Lord, there was nothing, there was no well, there was no stream to fetch water. When Hagar was crying out for her own son, Lord is opening up the stream. And if you read in Isaiah chapter 43, the whole chapter is talking about the confidence, creating a new confidence out of wilderness. So here God is also working in the history through Moses, saying that you stretch out your staff and put it on the sea and it will open. You will see a dry land and you can cross over. For God, nothing is impossible. Everything is possible. God can change all the situations. Yes, my dear friends, today we are very much disturbed, very much saddened by our own situations. We are counting days. First we counted for 21 days, then we counted for 14 days, now again 14 days. How long we can wait? How long can this Red Sea can be crossed over? Do we have hope? But God says, do not be afraid. I am here to take you further. So God says to Moses, what he clearly says, ask people to go forward. Don't cry and shout the place where you are finding difficulty. Go forward. That is the promise that God is giving to us. We have to go forward. Do not be afraid, because I am with you. So go forward. Shall we take this promise as for our own context? And can we try to go forward from this situation? Can we understand that God is really taking care of us, God is protecting us, God is also caring for us? Secondly, when we look at the gospel lesson that was read to us, here Jesus is directly speaking to his own disciples. And there was a confusion, there was a discussion among the disciples, and Jesus also trying to teach, and who is the way and how is the way and how to reach the eternal life, eternity. And if you read about the life of the disciples, they were not, at times they were not strong enough to take the matter, whatever was discussed with Jesus in faith. They always had a doubt, questions. It's good that we also have people around us, among us, who raises questions, who also have a doubt, and we'll also try to clarify. And here Jesus is speaking to them, and John chapter 14 verse 1 begins like this: "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me." So that's a paradoxical statement, and if you clearly watch, if you clearly notice, and if you say there's a paradoxical, but there is no paradoxical statement, but then it's a unification statement. What unifies? Christ and Father is one. That's what Christ is trying to say. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and I prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. At times what happens in some of our families, they will say, first I'll go to US, I'll settle there, and then I'll see that I'll prepare a way for you, and I'll find a job for you, and you can also come and settle. If not in US, at least I'll try to find some jobs in Canada. And some say, I'll try to go first to UK, settle there in London, and then I'll try to find a way for you to come to London. But in today's context, I don't know how many of you would like to travel to US and also to London because of these COVID-19 situations. I guess you'll all be afraid to go to US, right? Here, Christ is giving promise. What is that promise? He says, I'm going first. I'm going ahead. I'm preparing. I'm going to prepare a place for you to dwell forever and ever. I'm going to prepare a place for eternity, which will have no thirst. You will have no thirst, no tears, no hunger, nothing. And you will be singing all praises and honor and glory for the Lord Almighty. So I'm going to prepare a place for you. And he also says, I have many mansions. I have many dwelling places. It so happened, there was a discussion among the denomination leaders, and they said, we are very much divided within our own denominations. And if at all there is a heaven, can we imagine that we are all going to the same heaven? And can we imagine that we can all be united? Can we have oneness in the heaven to worship the Lord Almighty? That was the question placed before all the denomination leaders. And one priest from the Kerala said, yes, very much. We can have our own dwelling places, because Jesus promised that I have many dwelling places in the heaven, which means what? I have many mansions, which means what? All the denominations, we have got our own heavens, so we can enjoy sitting before the throne of Lamb of God. See, that's how even we are divided, not only here, and we are trying to divide even the heaven also. But let us try to understand the concept. Jesus is promising that he is going ahead and we also should follow him. We should also emulate him. He has set an example, he has set a way so that we can also follow the same way. And when you travel by road, you see all the signs, right? You have the signs towards left, you have signs towards straight, right? And you have signs also to take U-turn. And nowadays we also have the Google Maps, right? Which leads us very correctly, which leads to our destinations. We don't need to worry about anybody. We don't need to ask. We don't need to stop our vehicle at some points and ask for directions. The Google Map exactly takes us to the destination. And here Jesus says, "I am here. I am very much here to take you to the destination that is eternal life. So I am going ahead. I am going to come back again." That is the promise that Jesus is giving, and he says, "Let your heart not be troubled." Moses is telling to people, do not be afraid, because Yahweh is going before us. Here Christ is saying, let your hearts not be troubled, because I am going ahead to prepare a way for you. And in the fourth verse, is, and you know the way to the place where I am going. Then our disciples with question comes here. Who is that? I don't use the phrase doubting Thomas, because as if we don't have doubts, we always brand Thomas as a doubting Thomas. But here I would like to say, a disciple with questions, a disciple who longs for clarity, a disciple who longs to learn everything. Let us approach positively Thomas. Here Thomas also comes, intervenes and says, Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? And he's a very good student. He is trying to put more questions before Jesus. He is trying to place himself in the correct position. So he is trying to learn so many things. So Jesus says, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. So Jesus is making a very clear statement. I am the way, truth and the life. Truth, way, truth and life are very important things, right? Jesus says, I am the way, the truth and the life. He is the life giver. He is giving us life, and he is the truth. If you know the truth, then the truth will set you free. So we have to know the truth about Jesus Christ, about his sufferings, about his death, about his resurrection, the passion towards humanity. And he said, the beginning of his ministry, when he started his ministry at Galilee, he says, repent yourself, as the John the Baptist also said, declared, repent yourself, because the kingdom of God is near to you. So Jesus giving the promise. And Philip also here, he also comes in between, and he also says, Lord, show us the Father and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? If you carefully see in the beginning of this chapter, Jesus very clearly says, if the first verse itself, he says, believe in me and also believe in God. Believe in God and also believe in me. What does it mean? If you have seen the Son, Jesus Christ, you have also seen the Lord. You have also seen the Father. That's what he is trying to explain. So do we not believe that I am the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own. But the Father who dwells in me does his work. So Jesus is very much urging his own disciples to put the wholehearted trust on Jesus Christ. Jesus is trying to explain his disciples to fix all their trust on Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ alone, because they're able to see Jesus Christ. And Jesus says, I and Father are one. And can we say in this situation, we also hear in the television news, we also hear the domestic problems have increased. The problems, the conflicts between husband and wife is increased very much. And there is a strong violence increasing against women. And women are approaching now the police, the court, the law. They are not able to together, because the one day I was speaking to my own friend and he said, see, it will be very difficult to be in quarantine situation, because I usually go to my work. I hardly see my wife only for three hours. Early morning I get up, I get ready and I go to work. And late evening, 9 o'clock, I come back and I have a chat with my wife for some time, and I also see my children and then sleep, then get back. So hardly 2 to 3 hours only I try to manage. I usually manage my wife. But now, how can I manage 24 hours? See, this situation, right? We are not able to understand one another. Father and Son, they say, we are one another. We are one. And Jesus also promising and also making a very bold statement, if you have seen me, you have also seen the Father. And during our wedding ceremony, we have also heard the commandment, and also we have also heard the sermon saying, now no longer you are two, but you have become one. You have become one flesh. And are we trying to remain in the same promises? Can we say we are one, even in today's context? So, my dear friends, our families, the family situations, many families are breaking. And we could also hear many families are becoming broken families because of their intolerance. They are not able to face each other. They are not able to talk to each other. They are not able to show their love. All the time they are online, chatting with their own friends. They are not able to spend for their own family members. And here, Christ would like to unify us, saying, I and my Father are one. If you have seen me, you have also seen the Father. During last weeks, we heard many people are standing in a long queue for food in America, in other African countries, in other European countries, even in India. But if you could recently watch the television, what we experience, what we witness, people are standing in a long queue right from early morning to get liquor. And there was a person who bought, or a single person alone bought for about 50,000. And there are many people who really starved to death, who really don't have food, proper food, but they would like to have liquor. All the states, and even now Tamil Nadu also, they have opened up the liquor shop, and people are standing in a queue, age-wise. They are divided age-wise. The older people can come in the morning and collect by producing your Aadhaar card, and the younger people can come in the afternoon. They don't have a peace in their mind. Their mind is longing for something. They are finding difficult to cope up with their own ways. But you and I are having Jesus Christ as our way. And He is truth, and He is life. He is life-giving bread. And He is the one who can really feed us. So can we accept Jesus, even in today's context? Believing Christ can be possible in our today's context, because He is our way. When I started the sermon, I asked the question, can we trust Jesus Christ as our way in today's context? Yes, my dear friends, even today, in this pandemic situation, COVID-19 situations, Jesus can be the way. Jesus is the only way because he is the truth and he is the one who gives life for all of us. Life in abundance to enter into eternity. So this Messiah is going to come back. The risen Christ is going to come back. Are we ready to accept the Messiah when he comes back? Can we say boldly that I'll be with him? Jesus says, I'm going ahead to prepare a place for you. And after preparing the place, and he's going to come back, I'm going to take his bag. And are we ready to go with him with a smiling face? It's a challenge. Shall we bow our heads and look to God in prayer? Merciful God, source of life, thank you, Lord, for this promising word. Even in today's context, we understand that Christ can be our way. Christ can lead us, and Christ can take us further. As you also promised, and led the people of Israelites through the Red Sea, go forward. Yes, Lord, help us to go forward, not to look back the enemies, because you have put down all the enemies and we no longer will be able to see the enemies. Help us to understand Christ Jesus, who is the life-giving spirit and who can give us life. In Christ's mighty name we pray. Shall we all rise and affirm our faith by saying the Apostles' Creed together? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. The third day he rose again. He ascended to heaven. He seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen. Good morning, everyone. Hope you're all safe at your home and trying to be safe at your home. Don't come out of your home unless until it is necessary. Let's also abide with the guidelines given by the government of India and also government of Tamil Nadu in our state. Thank you, friends, for a good response for the relief work. And we have received quite some amount towards the Feeding the Hungry project, and we are able to do for some people, those who are needy, those who are hungry. And I would like to remind here about paying about your subscription, also sending your thanks offertory to a church account. The church account number, which is displayed on the screen, you may note down, and then you will send your offertory, thanks offertory, a tithe, a subscription, whatever way the Lord leads you to support the ministry of St. Stephen's. We also, on behalf of St. Stephen's family, we wish many blessings for the people, those who are celebrating their birthdays this week. And also a blessed anniversary, the couple will be remembering their wedding anniversaries this week. God bless you all. Shall we all look to God in prayer? Gracious God and loving Father, once again we come into your presence to give you thanks, O Lord. Thank you, Lord, for revealing us the truth that Jesus Christ is the way, and we have to believe in Christ that Christ is the way. Because he sets a good model, he sets and he guides us and he protects us through his own way to reach eternity, O Lord. Now we pray and bless the members, those who are celebrating their birthdays, and also remembering the wedding anniversaries. Continue to be with them, O Lord, as they enter into new year. That the blessings of heaven may be showered upon them. Peace and joy will run in their homes, O Lord. We also pray for the students. We commit and pray for all the students, especially during these times. They are also engaged in learning, O Lord. Through online classes, they are engaged. Help them to understand. Help them to learn clearly so that they will gain more wisdom, O Lord. We pray for our Sunday school children, all the children and young people. And we also pray for St. Hilda's students, O Lord. We pray for the correspondent, the principal, the coordinator, all the teaching and non-teaching staff, the supporting staff, into your mighty hand. As they learn together, as they grow together, as they experience wisdom from one another, we beseech God's wisdom to be intervened, O Lord. Take care of them, O Lord. Protect them wherever they are. Children are scattered in many places, in many towns and many cities, many states. But Lord, you be with them, O Lord. We also pray for the Laidlaw students, O Lord, the chairman, the principal, the headmaster, other teaching staff, and also the students, those who are spread across the country, O Lord. Be with them, O Lord, as they learn through online. Help them to understand in a better way, O Lord. We also pray for our church elders, those who are sick, those who are hospitalized, those who are not well, O Lord. We also pray for the past Red Cross members and each and every one of them, O Lord. Take care of them wherever they are. We also pray for Mr. Sugna Alexander. Be with her, O Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the successful surgery that has been done in the last week. And thank you, Lord, for giving her a good recovery. Help her to recover speedily, O Lord. Let your healing touch, that your healing hand may touch upon her and be comfortable. Be comfortable, O Lord. And we also pray for the nation leaders, the global leaders, those taking all the measures to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Help us to come out of this situation, O Lord. The Red Sea is COVID-19 for us in today's context, O Lord. You will help us. We know, we trust in you, O Lord. You will help us to come out of this situation. Help us, O Lord, so that we might cross over this COVID-19 situation as the Israelites crossed over Red Sea. Let your name be glorified through this, O Lord. We also pray for all the health workers, doctors, nurses, the government officials, those who are working in front line, O Lord. Continue to be with them. Take care of them. In Christ's mighty name, we pray. Amen. Thank you everyone for joining us to worship the Lord Almighty. Let us believe that Christ is the way, the truth and the life to move us forward. As God was speaking to Moses, asking people to go forward, let's also hope for the good thing to happen. Let us go forward in Christ's mighty name. God bless you, one and all. Amen.
We must go as a light to the nations. Take up his cross.